macOS Tahoe is set to release any day now. This is a major update, not just for macOS in general, but because it's the last version of macOS that will be available for any Intel Mac. So let's talk about which Macs are still supported, which ones got cut, what this means for the future of Intel-based Macs, and what you can expect from OpenCore Legacy Patcher. Let's get into it. macOS Tahoe will officially support all Macs with an Apple Silicon chip. So this includes the 2020 MacBook Airs and newer, 2020 MacBook Pros and newer, 2021 iMacs and newer, 2020 Mac Minis and newer, and all models of Mac Studio. On the Intel side, only a handful of models continue to be supported. They include the 2019 MacBook Pros, the 2020 MacBook Pros, and the 2020 iMacs. All other Intel-based Macs have been dropped from being officially supported for Tahoe. This includes the 2020 MacBook Airs, as well as the 2018 MacBook Pros, the 2019 iMacs, 2017 iMac Pros, and the 2018 Mac Minis. Most of these machines were running Sequoia without really any issues, but Apple is now making a clean break. And Apple has officially confirmed that this will be the last operating system update for any Intel Macs. Moving forward, any new versions of macOS will only be available for Macs with Silicon chips. Just because your Mac can't run Tahoe, however, it doesn't mean your Mac is obsolete or even not supported. Apple usually supports its latest three versions of its operating system, so that means that macOS Sequoia, macOS Sonoma, and macOS Ventura should all be supported. So if Ventura is the last operating system that your Mac can upgrade to, even though it's not updating to the latest OS, that's still considered a supported operating system. So it's when you can no longer upgrade to Ventura when you can actually consider your Mac unsupported. Now, if your Mac is unsupported for upgrading to Tahoe, is there any way to still install it? Well, there will be, eventually. The OpenCore Legacy Patcher team has already started early development for macOS Tahoe, and it should eventually support many of the Intel Macs that Apple dropped support for. But at this point, there's still no version available for Tahoe. The OCLP developers will have to wait until the public release of Tahoe before they can begin putting together a final install package for unsupported versions of Tahoe. Generally, unsupported versions are released almost at the exact same time as the supported versions, but I have heard some rumors that for Tahoe, we may have to wait until winter of 2025, but I'll of course keep you notified if that changes. Running Tahoe on unsupported Macs via OCLP is going to be a little bit more difficult than with previous versions. Some of the current issues and limitations include USBs not always working on older Macs, graphics acceleration is a bit unstable, especially if you're on a non-metal or have an older GPU. There are some issues with trackpad drivers on some MacBook models, like the 2014 MacBook Airs. And some of the Mac models with T2 security chips, like the 2018, 2019 MacBook Airs and MacBook Pros, still won't boot very well with OCLP. So the bottom line is that OCLP is still very much in development when it comes to Tahoe, and there currently isn't just a really easy plug-and-play version, but once it comes out, I'll be sure to give you guys all the details. More importantly, as Apple continues to lock down macOS for Apple Silicon-only hardware, future versions may be much harder or even impossible to patch onto Intel Macs, especially newer Macs with T2 chips. So while you may be able to use Tahoe via OCLP down the road, Tahoe could mark the end of unsupported installations, or at least force the community to adapt and change once again. If your Mac is on the supported list, you should be able to upgrade to Tahoe as soon as it's publicly available. If not, you'll still receive security updates for Ventura, Sonoma, and Sequoia. And down the road, OCLP will release a way for you to relatively easily install unsupported Tahoe on your Mac. And of course, once that's released, I'll publish a video right here giving you all the details on how you can do it too. Check out this guide right here as I really talk about the differences in all the different versions of macOS. And if you're doing an incremental update, check out this playlist right here where I put all of my unsupported videos. That's all I've got for you for today. I'm Anson Alexander, and I'll see you in the next one.